everyone. So this talk is about Ignite. I would like to say that I find that the harder the task is, the more it helps you ignite that passion in your mind, the more inspirational it is. And so find that thing which is really hard to do and you'll never regret it. So when I started, I wanted to do something, I didn't know what. And I didn't know at that time that Mumbai is one of the other noisiest city in the world. It's certainly the noisiest city in India, which means it probably is the noisiest in the world. And what we tried to do was to prove that this is a health issue. All of us are suffering, and to help Mumbai get well soon. We have a project called Get Well Soon Mumbai. This is a hearing test which we did in the BDD Chawls. The children at the Chawls are among the most affected by noise pollution, and there are many effects which are being had on all of them continuously. This is what Dr. Mahesh Bedekar, who filed a public interest litigation in the Bombay High Court, had to say at the time that he filed his litigation. He said, noise pollution adversely affects pregnant women and infants and can cause growth restrictions in a developing child intrauterine. Dr. Bedekar runs a nursing home, a maternity home in Thane, and he found so much noise in his area, he found his own patients being affected, and that's how he took up this case of noise pollution. These are the global standards on what levels of noise we should have for our own safety, for our own health. The World Health Organization has said that healthy noise levels should not exceed 55 dB in the day and should not exceed 40 dB at night. But unfortunately, you can look at this chart, you can see the noisiest cities in the world, the 10 noisiest, Mumbai is number one. This is a few years ago, and all Indian cities are pretty well represented on this list. So whatever are the effects that the WHO found, all of us are subject to them. These are the noise pollution rules. After the WHO came out with its report, which is called Community Noise, in 1985, the Indian Parliament had a debate and agreed that noise pollution is something that our citizens should not be subject to. They came out with this chart, which the WHO had recommended at that time, and they made it law by having the noise pollution rules notified in 2000. Unfortunately, today the discussion is more about how these rules are impractical for India because we are a noisy people, where the WHO has actually revised their norms downwards for the rest of the world. When we have water which is not clean to drink, I don't think we say, oh, these norms are impractical, let's revise them because we can't meet them. We try to make our water safe and clean so that our health is protected. So Mumbai, what are the sources of noise that are making us the noisiest city in the world? The first is through festivals. Our festival season is the loudest in the world. People who live along that route really suffer. And many people have asked me how I manage when I go there to take noise readings, whether anybody has ever threatened me, attacked me, whether people have said, what are you doing here? But no, you can see they're actually very curious. Because what happens is that they know by now that this is bad for them. People have come forward and said that we have restricted the timings in which we do this. But it's a little while, it doesn't matter. And unfortunately, that's what they're being taught, that if it's for a little while, it doesn't matter, which is very far from what the medical research says. It's not only festivals, we all have our private functions, we have birthday parties. This is the noise that went on when a Bollywood star was released from jail. This is how we celebrate almost everything that we think is fun, but it is not fun except for that time, very short time in which we are making ourselves deaf. So that for the next time that we want to have fun, we have to have fun at a still louder level. Dr. John Panikkar, coordinator of the National Initiative for Safe Sound of the Indian Medical Association. Awaaz Foundation has partnered with the Indian Medical Association because we believe that noise is a health issue. So he says that noise pollution adversely affects every part of the human body, including the heart, brain and all organs. It can cause heart disease, high blood pressure, mental illness and deafness. So deafness we all know about. but how many know that mental illness is related directly to noise pollution? The road rage that we read about, the rage in trains where women actually scratch each other and claw each other and have to pull the emergency buttons. Do we know how much of this is caused by noise pollution? Do we know people who have died because of noise pollution? They are not reported, these stories. Here's how the most obvious of these ill effects takes place. It causes hearing loss because noise is a wave, it's a pressure wave which hits your ear. In fact, that's how you measure noise levels, by measuring the pressure on your eardrum. And it can cause, if the pressure is too much, it can cause your eardrum to rupture. This happens at levels above 120 dB. I showed you a slide a little while ago which showed that Mumbai in the festival season crosses 123 dB even without firecrackers. When you use firecrackers, often it crosses 140 dB and we think it's safe for children. Dr. Jagde, consultant ENT surgeon who should know how it affects your ears, says exposure to noise pollution above 80 decibels for 8 hours a day for 8 years will induce permanent deafness. Shorter exposure of higher decibel levels also damages the eardrums. The World Health Organization says that 27% of the overall population of India suffers disabling hearing loss. Disabling, as in handicap, against 11% in many other countries, and only 3% in North African countries which are less urbanized, where the noise pollution is much less. Nearly 48% of Indians over 65 suffer debilitating hearing loss, compared to only 18% in other places. 12.3 million children and 18.8 million adults of our region suffer debilitating hearing loss. This is a health epidemic. Why are we subjected to these high noise levels? There are many causes. One of them is our recreation. The other is something we do every day, that is the traffic. We honk. All of us honk because we believe honking is necessary. Our driving schools teach us to honk and we think we can't drive without honking. This is a hearing test we did of policemen in Mumbai. We found that over 70% have severe hearing loss, and that's because they're standing on the road. If 70% of them have it, then certainly a good percentage of us have it too. And that extends from the slum dwellers right to the richest people, because we are all subjected to noise. So here's what we're doing about it. Honking is a disease. It causes disease and it is a disease. It's a disease because you're hurting yourself and it spreads. It spreads when you honk unnecessarily, somebody else gets inspired, in a wrong way inspired, and they honk. We need to get inspired to stop honking, not to inspire more people to honk. So Dr. Amit Desai talked about mental illness, but it affects the mental health, and because it creates a spike in adrenaline levels in the bloodstream and alters the biochemistry of the brain. That's how it causes mental health. That's where road rage comes from, to a large extent. Honking that horn is hurting your heart. This is the campaign that we have started. We've started many campaigns, but our focus right now is honking. We worked for years on other types of noise, festival noise, loudspeakers, but now I think it's time that we take on honking. This is what it does to your heart. Dr. Altaf Patel, who says that it increases stress hormones in the body, which increases blood pressure, and it has a direct effect on your heart. Heart attacks can occur, and they do occur, from exposure to sudden loud noise. People have died in hospital because we don't spare hospitals either. And we don't attribute it to noise, but the whole noise pollution case came up by the Supreme Court because a 10-year-old girl was raped and people could not hear her screams because of loudspeakers nearby. So that's noise. Let's declare independence from honking. We tied up with the Times of India and had this no honking week, which ended with a no honking day, and I think every day from then on should be a no honking day. I hope that it's going to be like that. So how do you not honk? The first thing you need to do is tell your driver. Tell the driver, tell your husband, tell your father, tell yourself, tell your rickshaw driver, your taxi driver, tell all your drivers, don't honk. My driver hasn't honked for the last 15 years that he's been with me. he knows that, and his driving is fine, he's safe. He reaches as quickly as anyone else. He doesn't give himself high blood pressure and he doesn't give me high blood pressure. So join the movement, tell the driver. This is the launch event of Tell the Driver, which we did with the Thane traffic police and the Thane police. All of us told our drivers, I hope many of them stopped honking. Then we did it with school children, with others. These are the Women's Graduate Union, which are senior citizens. So in one picture you have senior citizens and school children. All of them don't want people to honk. They all disturb, your studies are disturbed by noise, your careers can be disturbed by noise. Here are some two more school children, one of them is my son, who are telling the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, let's put noise pollution behind bars, that's where it belongs. Noise pollution has no place in our lives, and there I am the voice against noise. I would like all of you to be the voice against noise. So this is what we are saying, voice against noise, your Awaaz against noise, people against noise, children against noise, good doctors against noise, animals against noise, everybody is hurt by it. And also, no religion tells you, nobody tells you that noise is part of any kind of traditionally any ceremony. All ceremonies came about in the years and eras before loudspeakers were invented. Let's talk of peace, let's not talk of noise. Therefore, gods against noise. All gods are against noise, whether any religion that it may be. We talk of calming your mind, we talk of achieving a calm state of mind, of being loving your neighbor, loving your everybody, attaining, they call various names, but attaining some kind of state of peace. No god tells you that noise is about religion. So with this whole your Awaaz against noise, gods against noise, the High Court cases that we did, the Supreme Court cases where a number of orders have been passed, we made some unexpected allies, expected and unexpected. The people who we thought would oppose us joined us, and many people who I thought would join us opposed us. And this happened because people who were my friends wanted me to make exceptions for them through the courts and allow their noisy functions to continue. And when I didn't do that, they became antagonistic. But people who I had thought are going to be against me, people, organizers of these functions, who are making money out of these functions, I thought that there'll be a tough battle making them stop. But in many cases, it so happened, and it happened in Navratri, the first year after the High Court order in 2004, when after the function, all loudspeakers stopped at 10 o'clock and there were no loudspeakers in silent zones. In addition to that, one of the largest organizers of Navratri called me after Navratri was over and said, my daughter is doing a college project, can you help her do it on noise pollution? So that's only in India, only in Mumbai, that we have the spirit where we are willing to understand, we're willing to change, we have it in us, and that's how all those students and senior citizens, everybody was out there on the road, and they have cooperated, they have participated. What we are now doing, I started out because there was no data available. Because of the lack of data, it was very difficult to control noise. But I started with a small handheld meter and started measuring noise. So now, because that data has, in the beginning, was the only available data, the government decided that they would also start measuring, and they did measure. They took a number of steps. They have made noise barriers in some of the noisiest areas. They have even made it part of the planning process. They have agreed to do a noise mapping study of Mumbai. They have taken measures to control noise from various kind of events. And most importantly, they have done it because people have started complaining. People know how to complain. They know you can call the police. The police have set up systems and you can get noise stopped at 10 o'clock. Now you can even download a free noise meter onto your phone. It's just a free app. Download it, take the readings, complain to the police on 100, that's the control room number. Give them the reading and get a complaint number from them. With that complaint number and a chart, you can follow it up and the police will cooperate. This is where we start from. firecrackers which were beyond the threshold of pain, 140 dB regularly. Now, because of the data, the tests, the complaints from citizens, the level of crackers which are available in the market have come down a lot. Now they are all below 120 dB, which is still very high. People have stopped using them, and we have gone on now to this. This Diwali, Mumbai was the only city in India where noise levels have gone down. They have gone down for the last 5 years here. In every other city, they have continuously gone up. Levels of firecrackers have dropped, and we have Mumbaikars to thank for this. So this is a hoarding which was put up by the traffic police on the main hoarding side. And thank you, Mumbai.